I will speak about deep matters about water. It's not like the surface matters where I just speak and tell you some speculative arguments and without proofs behind it. I will explain you material from Mr. Asenbaum, who is my coach and my partner, and he has so much knowledge. He gathered 10 years knowledge about this matter, and now we go really deep. Questions which you never hear normally, and questions which are really interesting, and I hope you will enjoy it. Alkaline water is nearly not well known in the European countries, but in the United States and Korea and Japan and other Asian countries, it is really well known and many people use it daily. And alkaline water has the advantage that it has a nice taste. It is about the hydrogen. The hydrogen tastes really special. It has like this fresh taste of something which you don't get nowhere else. Only in alkaline water you can really get that amount of hydrogen. The hydrogen can be around 1500 micrograms, which is really tiny amount if you measure it by weight, but it is like so much bubbles. Hydrogen is like has no weight at all nearly, and 1500 micrograms can be solved in the alkaline water. But once you fill the water up with the directly under a submersive, with a submersive technique, directly with a tap below the water surface in your glass, then you will get a milky water. It will be like milk, white, because the bubbles, they those who cannot be solved, they will swim around, and once you have that glass, you can drink it immediately, and you will really feel the difference as it makes some kind of activation in your head. You get like awaken and like present. Not many people speak about that. They speak mostly alkaline water, ionized water, but it's more about the hydrogen, as the hydrogen, it brings you the electrons into the water, and that means that our water, alkaline hydrogen enriched water, has a negative ORP, that's the oxidation reduction potential. That means that this water doesn't rust metallic stuff, it does antioxidate it. It is like putting the rust away. So if you have rusted metal, you can put it in alkaline water, and the first 1-2 hours it will make the contrary, it will take away the rust. And this makes it also in the body. So you drink it, and those things what normally would rust you, alkaline water, does donate an electron, and this oxidating material will not harm your cells, will harm nothing, it will not make you older, as the hydrogen has donated its electron. I mean, we must not go too deep in these matters, as it's a little bit more complicated. I try to explain it like more easy, that everybody can understand it. But this is mainly the reason why we do it. Hydrogen enriched water. It's like not carbonated water, hydrogenated water. It has the bubbles, it tastes much better, and it is not like the pH value at the lower level where normally the government allows to drink. It's 6.5. It's on the higher part. It's at the 9.5 part, as the government allows like around maximum 9.5 or 9.0, depending on the country you live in. And for this reason, it's really better to drink the water on the other side what the government allows, and not on the lower side. Why 6.57 neutral water or slightly acidic water? Better alkaline water, I would suggest. The point is, the more you drink this water and you have separated the acidic minerals, not all of them, but most of them are separated. For this reason we call it ionized water, so the water will be separated in hydrogen and oxygen, but also we separate the other ions. So we have like more minerals which are alkaline, calcium, magnesium, kalium, sodium and that stuff. And we now drink that here inside. We drink it. It is like you put alkaline minerals into your body. It doesn't depend where you put it in. They are inside. You don't put like acidic and alkaline minerals. You put always additional alkaline minerals inside. Whatever the stomach does, it doesn't matter, because in your body, incomplete, you will have more alkaline minerals. So for this reason, alkaline water is the only thing which really can make your acidicity in your body away, as we add all the time alkalinity. So this is the one point, and the other point is when you eat now something and you have like food in your stomach, the stomach is something like this, there is like the possibility when it's like a sack, you know, it's a food sack. And it has like the, I can show it here, I will show you a picture, but you can, it's possible that the food stays in the sack, and if you drank afterwards alkaline water or whatever water, it has the possibility to go away over the food. Also the acidicity, which is important, depends also on your harmony of your alkaline to acidic minerals. And if you're all the time acidic, we have also a problem to neutralize later on the acids in the intestines, because it has to be neutralized. You need alkaline minerals. You need enough of them. If you don't have them, then you don't have hairs, because you lose the hairs. You lose otherwhere the minerals when you don't you donate it in order to survive, because your stomach acid, the neutralization of it is really important afterwards. When you would stop drink these Coca-Cola and other acidic drinks, there are so many acidic drinks, real acidic drinks. When, if you would stop that, then you would really have a better chance to get more alkaline. The worst things are not meat and other things. The worst things are this liter per liter bottles of real acidic beverages. So if you look on the mineral water, bottled mineral water, carbonated, they are really acidic, man. So, and Coca-Cola, coffee, orange juice, other juices, green tea, all of that stuff is acidic. So no one is caring about that. They think like, oh, I start to eat better and then I will feel better. No, that's not the case. For sure you will feel better when you eat more green stuff. I mean, that's logical. And not only eat all the time meat. You will feel better, definitely, when you stop that. But finally, drinking is the main problem. And there we can now start with the alkaline water. You just drink that every day. You start it in the morning. You use it for everything. You use it also even for food to activate it. You can use it for also some other smoothies and anything what you use. I even drink wine together with alkaline water mix. You can activate food by just putting them into the alkaline water, freshly produced, like in a bowl. And you keep it there like 10 minutes and you will see, taste that the food really changes, give life back again. Because anything fresh, what you can get directly from the tree or from the ground, which is fresh and ripe, this contains electrons, this contains hydrogen, this has really the potential of give you life, and not like some dead things we typically eat processed and no energy at all inside. We can measure that. I'm not speaking about something which is speculative. Karl-Heinz Asenbaum and other experts, they measured so much. What about the juice of the fruit when it's fresh? What about when I activated 10 minutes with alkaline water? Is it fresher? Does it has more ORP, oxidation reduction potential? And normally the maximum oxidation reduction potential, the most freshest you can get is spinach. And this, it should be fresh spinach. And this is around 300, 350 millivolt in the negative, minus. So for this reason, we recommend also that one should not drink higher ORP values, not constantly. You can drink anything what you want. You can drink hard alcohol also. You will not die for it, from it, as our body is a really compensator. It can compensate anything what you can imagine. But finally, you get older. In the young years, you compensate, you say, yeah, no problem. Oh, at one point, oh, where are the hairs with 25, 30, 35? Oh, why do I get gray hairs? Oh, I'm getting fat. Oh, this, oh, my, I have problems with the bones or whatever. You know, those are the typical compensation signs of your body, that you have lost things. You have lost your life energy. And so only by drinking this really tasty, fresh, produced, hydrogenated, alkaline water, pH 9.5 or plus, I mean 10, that should be also then the maximum. What else do we want? Is it easier? Do you need to drink water? So this is our solution, and for just being more healthy. This is the one part of the alkaline water. The second part is it is really supporting you if you have like diseases like cancer and other stuff. It really gives you so many therapeutics, naturopaths, they use this water. They use it in stronger values, smaller amounts, or in the normal values, pH 9.5, recommending that to the clients. Even cancer people, everybody who has some kind of problem, normally you can measure that in your saliva, your pH value of your body, by just putting an indicator paper on your saliva. After drinking alkaline water, you can again 10 minutes later measure that the indicator paper will get more alkaline. You will see a difference, a change with and without. Just try it out. If you drink it once, you will see, wow, something is different with this water. And I get so much feedback from my clients, they all say the same. The whole family starts to drink water. People who don't drink water, they started to drink water. I know people who never in their life drank water, or who don't know when they were last time drinking one glass of water. Exactly for those people, this water is really very special, because you really taste the difference. You drink it, your body will accept it, and your body will want more. What happens if the water is not so good, or technological water, some processed water, what happens? Then your body says, yeah, I know, I have to drink, your mind says, and then you try to drink, at the end of the day you haven't drank enough. That's the typical solution. So people who want to save some, who want to lose some weight, the weight losing gurus and trainers, they should be more drinking trainers, because most people just drink wrong. The proofs why the water really makes something in your body, it makes you healthy, is because you can see the lifeblood analysis through the microscope. You can see inside the body, inside the blood, one drop of blood, and you can see how vivid the blood is. Is there more like stagnance, or is it moving, the blood plates and all these things? What else is inside? Is there many garbage inside or whatever? So people make so many times, I got many clients who visit the doctor who makes such lifeblood analysis, and then they call me and say, I want to have an ionizer, because they see what happens when you drink alkaline water. They see, wow, it's so fast. You will see here now the video, it's moving so fast in the blood, everything is vivid again. It's not like, oh, I'm sleepy. You know, it's like vivid. And for this reason, maybe you know somebody who can make a lifeblood analysis, and there you can see definitely the difference, or you just see this video here, what we make and what is inside this video. So you will feel it then, that what we show you in the video.